Brought to you by Mr. Crow's TV, streaming from Tempe, Arizona. And we're live in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey guys, Jordan here, host of Real Estate Pros on Lister Pros TV, and today we have a two-time guest, Tony Ray Baker.
Do I get a jacket?
Yeah. Like, you get a, like you get a shirt.
Nah, I get a little jacket on like SNL. I want a robe or whatever that is.
So, so it's been a few months since you've been on the show, so...
Has been.
I guess there's probably people watching that still don't know who you are, so we'll still give you an opportunity to... kind of introduce yourself.
Okay.
What brokerage you at? You know, what interested you in being here in Tucson?
Okay. Well, I'm Tony Ray Baker, and I've been with Tierra Antigua Realty since they opened, and I actually started in business about 1994. So what, 24 years?
Yeah.
Yikes. So my business has been, we take care of about 600-700 clients that are all referrals. So we didn't do much marketing and advertising at the beginning of my career. Now we actually are very savvy with websites and technology because we all had to become smarter with that stuff. And so we actually have a second type of business coming in from that. So that's, you know, what we do. The our big push right now is helping downtown development.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So, which is a really fun project because we have a thriving downtown thanks to the streetcar 3 years ago.
Yeah.
And but one of the problems I see downtown, and I saw like 4 or 5 years ago, is we didn't have any development for people to have ownership in the area. So there's a lot of houses around the area, but not enough. And they're bringing in probably about 3,000 new apartments into that
really
sector.
Yeah, I've seen, downtown Tucson looks significantly different than it used to.
Right. And all thanks to that.
It seems like there's a lot of like condos and different kind of development down there. Or are they building houses downtown?
Condos are a false.
Yeah.
There's no condos. They're all apartments. Unfortunately, right now, we'll see about 3,000 new apartments coming in. The we do need real condos, but that's a banking issue and a building issue.
Oh, gotcha.
So
gotcha.
We're working on trying to get that solved right now. But housing, I'm excited about because we actually, in that little Menlo Park area, which is really close to the beginning of the streetcar, over at the Mercado. The Mercado changed standards over there because they put in $500,000 homes in the middle of Menlo Park, and those houses are running $500,000 to $1 million.
Wow.
And so when the developer had the vision to do that and the vision to create all the little miniature city that's to come, it changed Menlo Park big time because what we're doing is we have, my team represents 5 builders in the area. And so what we have happening now is we help people sell their homes or remodel their homes to get them back on the market. So we're seeing prices right now for 1,600 square foot homes. We're up in the 350 to 400 range, which in a few years ago would have been 100, 150.
Yeah.
So it's very exciting to see what's going on in there.
So that's all driven by the development around the area. Obviously, I think downtown wasn't very scenic before. Now it kind of has like its own little vibe and feel to it.
Right. I think the awards coming in from around the world, I think, have made a huge change to Tucson as well because UNESCO gave us the first the award for the first gastronomy city in Northern America.
Really?
And then the IFEA voted for Tucson as the Dubai and Tucson took the award for best festivals and events for last year. And then the APA just announced Congress Street was the award, the city to get the award for best planned area for streets. So with those things happening, we're getting that news out there
kind
around
the
world. And it's really made that, it's reasons why Caterpillar's bringing 1,000 people or however many they're bringing into the area. And they're building right at Mercado. So, and those things are happening because that little streetcar made it. And now it's like the little engine that could.
So I'm not from Tucson, but what is the streetcar and what's the story behind that kind of started?
So Streetcar was planning from the way back in the back when Rio Nuevo started, and there was, you know, controversy over Rio Nuevo and mishandling. But the reality is that Rio Nuevo did start the planning process on how to bring the downtown area back to life. The Streetcar was designed to connect four major shopping areas, which would be the Mercado District, which is now under full, you know, construction, then to through downtown, down 4th Avenue Shopping District, and over through the University Main Gate area. And the nice thing is that it actually goes to the, it actually pops over to the hospital, or Banner Hospital. So you've got a little light, you know, kind of little mini light rail streetcar running there and bringing people to over 350 venues.
Right.
So now that's why you're seeing the push to get into any area near that little streetcar, because people want to be within, you know, walking distance to the streetcar. It's that urban push. We all want to stop driving cars. We want to start walking and, you know, taking that little streetcar. So that's what's happening.
So what's the big, so turning the conversation to real estate, what are the big drives to people wanting to live? I think you already mentioned some of those, that urban lifestyle, not wanting to drive cars and stuff like that. But,
yeah,
you know, why are you seeing that a lot of people are kind of migrating to the new downtown district area?
Well, first of all, they're bringing in, I think they're opening a new business every 8 days down there. That's nuts.
Wow.
A new business coming in every 8 days. That was the last number I heard. So that's pretty crazy. But, so millennials, for example, younger generation want to get to that area because there's great chefs coming in. There's great, venues, retail, all that stuff coming into the area. And then ironically, the retirees are doing the exact same thing. So we're selling million-dollar homes in the foothills and moving them into downtown because they don't want to drive either. It's really a great world where you can just walk to the park or jump on a bike share, ride this, you know, streetcar, and have everything at your fingertips. It's back to that European lifestyle.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think that's what you're seeing in this beautiful little downtown that's growing up.
Mm-hmm. So and it really seems cool. Like a lot of millennials are kind of, they like that lifestyle.
Yeah, I like that lifestyle.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm in between. Yeah. I'm in between.
You're not a millennial?
No. Yeah, but thank you. I probably would declare myself as a millennial. No, I'm not. I'm in the middle of the two groups, and it's a good place to be for me because I identify with both, and I get it. And I would love to be in that, too. I'm actually scouting for my own property down there. Someday I'll be in that area.
Yeah.
Yeah. So especially that Mercado section, what's happening there, there's so much change available because of the land available and the housing available. So, and it's all at the beginning of the streetcar. So you can be in that section, you know, and find a bunch of really nice houses. Well, I'm going to say that lightly.
Yeah.
You won't find a bunch of nice houses right now. Here's the irony of this. So when we're building, almost every house we put on the market, we didn't put them on the market last year. We actually sold them before they went to market.
Really?
Because all I have to do is put a sign in the front yard and I get bombarded with phone calls because the people are driving the neighborhood streets trying to see what's happening.
So do you focus primarily your real estate business in the downtown area, or you cover all
no,
Tucson area?
Yeah, I think that's a good question. We have about 700 clients, and they are all over Pima County. So we work with people everywhere, and it's not about housing for us. It's about people.
Right.
So as long as we're a good fit, that's all that matters. All right, at the end of the day, if we can make a happy a client happy and get them through that process, that's what we care about. But what's happened for me is that I've taken on this development project downtown. So besides all of the regular business we do with our referral business, we are really helping the builders downtown get their product out there and helping them get that sold.
Yeah, absolutely. So if there's a builder or real estate agents watching the show and they're say, hey, Tony, we want you to help me find a place, or somebody relocating, because there's a lot of people coming from out of state with Caterpillar and other companies that are in Tucson, how do people get a hold of you?
Thank you for asking that too, because we actually have a list of people and we actually notify them of every house we're building and coming up before they go to market, so they won't find them on any of the websites or public stuff. They won't find them anywhere. So they
Since you work with the builders.
Right, because then I just try to start getting them out. So we keep a list called Coming Soon, and everybody who's on that list, I just notify them every time we have something new coming up. And usually we sell every house off that list or off of a sign call because the signs are up. But they can contact me at TonyRay@ctucsonhomes.com, our website, C-Tucson Homes. And if they just email TonyRay@ctucsonhomes and tell me what they're looking for on an email, I'll gladly get back to you and help put you on the list if you want to be on that list.
Awesome. Well, yeah. Thanks for joining me on Real Estate Pros for the second time. We'll have to have you come on again and talk a little bit more about...
I want that robe.
Yeah, you need a robe. I'm going to bring a shirt for you next time, and we'll talk more on the technology side of your business, because I think there's a lot there as well. So
yeah, that's a fun side. Yeah. So, thank you for
having me. Awesome. Well, thank you, Tony, and we will see you guys on the next episode.